Hey, Allie, what are you doing? Did you find something to rip up? Are you ripping something up? Let's see what it is. Can you show Dad? Very good. I don't know what that is.
I'm bad at doing things in small amounts. When I read the whole book in one night. When I find a TV show, I finish the entire season without breaks. When I decide to paint something, I refuse to focus on anything else until I get it done. With friends and projects and internships and classes, when I start going, I don't stop. And yeah, I can call it good work ethic because I work hard at everything. But maybe it's a bit too much perfectionism too. It's the curiosity for everything that seems to be ever-present in everything I do, because I have to know more and do more and see more because I just want to understand. So when I'm asked what I've learned in life this far, I'll say, yeah, working hard is important, and perseverance is good too, but the most important thing is trust and love and letting people in, because I know that it doesn't matter that I've jumped off the cliff if I don't know that I have people at the bottom to catch me, or at least try to. Attempts are nice. I am the most me when I'm with others, even though I'll get tired when it's done, because for as much as I love my room and my cat, there's a different kind of life I can live when I'm screaming shivers by Natural and barreling down the 5 on the way home from slow, or smacking someone upside the head at D&D because someone brought out the cardboard again. No matter where I am or how far I get, my life will be successful if I have my people around me. Well, I guess I could also be successful if I have plants, and maybe some paint and a brush or a glue stick and a random piece of paper. That could potentially be a memory. In my 18 years so far, I've tried a lot of different things that make me happy, and those three hobbies seem to stick. I can't tell you how many hours I've spent working out in my garden or evaluating the health of my indoor plants. There's too many canvases in my room from painting those random things that bring me joy and allow me to show the world how I see it. And despite my parents' wishes, my room is filled with scraps of paper of random things from my daily life that I can use to scrapbook. Which definitely seems like a weird hobby to have as an 18-year-old, but the memories I collect in my journals make it worth it. The skies are paying homage to the way I'll always think of you. Don't get me wrong, I do love science and the kind of curiosity that brings as well. If there's one person in the world that I admire the most, it would be my mentor Jess from Scripps Research, because she truly encouraged me to pursue my own dreams because she worked so hard for her own. Seeing a woman in science excel the way that she has reminds me why I'm working hard and doing the things I want to do now, because she has succeeded, and I can do it too. Which I guess brings me to what I'm doing next. Hopefully finding a better sleep schedule somewhere. I like high school, but it did teach me that I can run on way less sleep than I probably actually need to be a functioning human. I'll go to UC Berkeley and study biochemistry and maybe work in a lab for a bit so I can get into a good PhD program. I'll see the world and I'll fall in love and adopt another cat and read books and water my plants and hopefully just find time to do the things that I love even when my life will be changing so much. I'll meet people and mess around with my friends and develop weird relationships with the people I see in passing, but through it all, I'll be curious and have fun. And that's really all I could ask for.